Hello, folks. Good to see you. I hope you're blessed here with Scott at the church office. Ben's gone this week, so no fancy editing on our PastorCast. This is just raw. Scott and I are just going to sit here and talk and give you some updates and hopefully keep you posted on things going on with the church. So, Scott, you have some updates first. You want to share with the flock?
Yeah, just a couple things. Some real celebratory news. John and Carolyn Hoy became grandparents for the very first time earlier, I believe it was this week or over the weekend, and so congratulations to them. Their Amen. Oldest daughter Amy had her first child with her new spouse, and so we're really excited for the Hoys, and congratulations to you all.
Congrats.
Hoy family.
Yep.
Also, as a reminder, we mentioned that Anthony and Megan Crockett are moving to Idaho. That is happening this coming Friday morning, bright and early, and so again, we love you guys. We will miss you. And we pray that God will be with you on your journey up there. It's an exciting time for you as well. And I believe we have another family leaving who you know very well.
Yeah, I mean, actually, we have a few more. I'm not going to say them all yet because some are a little later in the month and they're some on, you know, providential reasons or having to move, et cetera. So, Nelson and Dina DeMarco are going to be moving to Oklahoma. They've been back with the church now for some while. They were at the church a few years back. Nelson's a lifelong friend of mine. I met him in junior high. We played in band together. He came to faith after me. On one level, sad to see him go, but I'm sure I'll be seeing him again. His dad still lives here in town, so we'll be saying goodbye to DeMarcos here in another week or two.
All right.
So, but it's God's providence, you know.
Yeah.
We sing the Lord gives and the Lord takes away. And I keep saying, Lord, do some giving here soon, because you're doing a lot of take away.
Yeah.
So let's talk about this last Sunday's outdoor service.
Yeah,
what did you think of that?
You know, it was really a blessing. I think that was the first time I didn't have the luxury or privilege to be with the church when we did reopen. That spell, I was just out of town with a lot of all that's been going on in my own life. And
that's right.
So that was the first time I'd been with the saints worshiping in,
well, since March.
4 months. So it was really an encouragement to sing with people, even though it was a little muffled, but it was just great to see people, hear other voices other than my own singing, and to praise the Lord together, to pray together. It was just a great encouragement to me. And I came with my two of my children, and I heard from others that they were equally blessed, and so it was just a sweet privilege that Fair Oaks gave us, and just real grateful to them. And I know it ministered to my own soul, and I heard that did the same for others. And you shared your own sort of personal testimony and about your own experience, and it'd be helpful, I think, for folks to hear that too.
Well, I mean, folks that weren't there, for me it was profound, because you know, you all been listening to my voice a lot and seeing my face, and I'm sorry about that, but I don't get to do the same. I was there the few weeks we did reopen, you know, so that was a blessing. But this was different because there was more of you, and it just seemed more in the flesh, you know, being outdoors, the air, and being around you and talking with many of you, and then hearing you all offer prayers, those that did pray, and praises, and that's what the experience was. It was deeply, deeply encouraging. I heard that from others as well. You know, we hope that many of you will be able to continue participating when we keep doing this. At least we have a plan for this week as well, because we had to book some Sundays ahead to know. Without knowing what our decisions are going to be or what's going to happen with the county or whatever, that we had to commit to something. So we already committed through this Sunday for sure. Mm. And I mentioned there on Sunday night, this past Sunday night, that we would be having the Lord's Supper there this coming Sunday. So that's something we should probably talk about. Let me just say this. I even had some questions afterwards that I wasn't clear, I guess, in one of the statements I meant, that I said, this coming Sunday, the Sunday morning service will still be going on like normal. I'll be preaching through the next part of the book of Acts. That's at 9 a.m. We'll stream it, and it'll get posted afterwards. We won't, however, be doing the Lord's Supper online, because for this first time that we're able to meet like this outdoors at 4 p.m., we really wanted to focus our time on the table, the Lord's Supper, where we're gathered, the church gathered at 4 p.m. It doesn't mean we'll keep doing it this way. We're just not sure, you know, how things are going to work out as far as all that's concerned, but we're really hoping a lot of you will plan for that. The you know, in terms of some of the you know, the protocols that we were following. If some of you weren't there last time, it was really, we're just doing what folks, our hosts, are asking us to do. Mm-hmm. There was a lot more shade than people, I think, thought ahead of time. That's why we went at 4 o'clock. If some of you stayed awake because of the heat, look, we're there an hour, and there's a lot of shade if you get there early and find your spot. So really hoping a lot of you come back. So it'll be the Lord's Supper at 4 p.m.,
yes.
A simple service again. It won't be a repeat of the morning service. We'll be singing again, praying, and have some kind of brief reflection on the Word. Maybe you could tell us more about what the staff has worked out for the elements, you know, the logistics on the elements.
Yeah, the way I was there last week, and my daughter and I participated in kind of the welcome table where there was hand sanitizer and masks, and we thought for this week we would do 3 stations like that that would have some hand sanitizer, some masks, even the QR code for worship lyrics, and at each one of those stations also we'll have those prepackaged communion elements that if some of you were here. That one Sunday we were open and we took communion together, we used those little prepackaged communion elements, and we'll use those again. So as you walk in, you can grab your mask and click on the QR code. You can grab one of those little prepackaged communion elements. If you're gluten-free, you'll have to bring your own gluten-free elements. And if you just want to be that much more cautious, you can bring your own juice as well if you're just concerned about touching the cracker and so forth. So We should have everything there that we need to follow protocol, to be able to share in the Lord's table together. And it really just should be a sweet time. We recognize not everyone can be there, but it's just really a unique time. And this really affords us the greatest opportunity to have the most people in one spot to share in the Lord's table together, which has been since February.
Yeah.
We've been able to do it probably. Like this, you know?
Yeah,
and
yeah.
So it should be a sweet time. So I think that about covers it.
I would just add to that, Scott, that, yeah, we realize some of you don't want to be there because you're high risk. You have underlying conditions, something like that. Again, we'll talk later about how we can best minister to you in light of that. And also, no one's going to think the less you, if you just, that's where you're at in your conscience and your own desire. We just do want to encourage those that can come and to be there, you know, to be there at 4 p.m. And, you know, like I said earlier, this was already pre-planned. We had to get at least 2 weeks out ahead. So the elders did begin a good discussion this last Tuesday on where we might be going in regards to the health safety limitations, all that, and ordinances. It was a good discussion. What's priority for us is how we, these elders, can best shepherd this flock mm-hmm. at this present moment in our situation. And so this affords us yet some more time to keep discussing that and working these things out. So this Sunday, we're already committed to the plans that you heard here. So at 9 a.m., live streaming, same things. We've been going through the Book of Acts. 4 p.m., outdoor service. All are welcome at Fair Oaks Baptist, and it will be centered around the Lord's table. So that's it for this week. It's real simple, making it easy on ourselves, and we hope that you guys are continuing to be encouraged. Thank you for your encouraging notes that you send to us. We are praying for you constantly. Last night was a good long time of deep thought and prayer for the flock. Thank you. God bless you.
God bless. Hope to see you Sunday.